Hello everybody, and welcome back to Elder Scrolls Online. Not an awful lot has happened since last episode. I think I've switched over to my restoration, I think. Inventory. Weapon, yes, Maple Master Restoration stuff. I switched over to that to give us a bit of a heal going on. We can still use the destruction skills that we have, but it just gives that little bit extra there for healing before we go into the wind tunnel where we need to go for the quest. So let's enter there. Okay, looks like it's straight away into the action then.
These totems seem to harness a combination of wind and spirit. I wonder if I can... Excuse me, do you mind?
Oh, really? We're here to stop the sea vipers.
Indeed. I suppose that's optimal. These sea viper rituals are barbaric, but quite effective. The hurricane they summoned to dash our fleet against Canopy's roost? That's nothing compared to their current efforts.
What's worse than a hurricane?
You clearly haven't studied the fundamentals of blood sacrifice. You see, these serpent-shaped statues, they're storm totems. They collect spirit energies from rune-marked subjects and channel it, like water through a funnel.
Okay, so how do we block the funnel?
Exactly the right question. It seems the sea vipers use a specialized lodestone to block the channel. Approach an active storm totem, hold forth the lodestone, and harmlessly siphon the energy away.
Make sure it's harmless.
Completely. Go ahead, don't be shy. It's not as though the storm totem's energies will cascade throughout your body until you're nothing but a lifeless, smoking husk. But do avoid standing in the puddles, would you?
That's really quite amusing. Okay. Let's have a look. Okay. Oh, there is a cave there.
Phenomenal. I knew proximity was the key. And look at you. Not even a hint of electrocution. You have the principle. Now to apply it to the other storm totems before... Well, best not to worry about that.
Worry me about what?
No, I really shouldn't worry you.
So, come on, tell me why the sea vipers need these storm totems.
I can't say for certain. It's one of two things, neither of which is good for anyone on this island. You don't stoop to blood sacrifice unless you need a lot of energy very quickly. And, well, to release it, just as quickly.
What does that mean?
Listen, you handle the storm totems. I'll determine how to best counteract the sea viper blood ritual without destroying Mistral. Does that seem equitable? The only certainty is the lack of time. You should hurry.
Okay, off we go then. So we are going into the cave. Hello?
Seems agitated.
Okay, on to the next one. Somebody fighting there. Well, there's a lot of people in here. I really am amazed. This game's been out a couple of years now, hasn't it? Still loads of people in the newbie zones, I would call them. Unless there's no such thing in this game. I could be wrong. There's still plenty of people doing the newbie stuff. Oh, hello. Hello. Whoop. Have that. Healing now, it's nice. Don't want any of that, I don't think. And it's nice to have all this company. Oh, I haven't got my pet out either. There we go. Four or five. Are we killing all this stuff as well? Kaboom! Woohoo, lovely! Anything interesting? Oh! Dwarf Magicka, great. Alright, let's move on to the next bit then, huh? Hello! They seem to spawn rather quickly. So it seems that my main problem is going to be Magicka regen. So I need to focus on getting that up. At some point. Hello.
This is Eelsil. Speaking directly to your mind. Find my Psijic projection near the tunnel exit. I know how to stop the Marma.
Okay, hello.
I know what they're planning. Through my Psijic projection, I observed an old ritual site north of Mistral. The Sea Vipers summoned a powerful creature known as a Storm Atronach. They're funneling all that energy into their bound Storm Slave.
Okay, what does that mean?
The creature can only hold so much energy before it discorporates. All the energy will wash over Kanathi's roost, killing anything it touches. Except for the thunderbugs, of course. Oh, and the mountain north of Mistral will shatter, leaving no trace of the town.
Well, that's not good, is it? We're going to be able to stop this.
Ah, there's the genius of their plan. How do you bind a creature made of storm energies? With the wind itself. Three ritual horns trap Storm Slave. But the lodestone now has enough storm energy to counteract the false winds. Elegant, yes?
Okay, what happens when I release the Storm Slayer from its bonds?
It will shed its corporeal form and safely release its stored energy. By safely, I mean in relation to Kanathi's roost. I recommend moving a fair distance away from Storm Slave when this happens. Perhaps keeping solid rock between it and yourself?
Okay, I'll sort the Sea Viper ritual.
You'll have no trouble. But in the event you do, I've opened a portal at a distance of 1 league from Kanathi's roost. There I'll tread water in the open sea until I've observed your success. Merely a precaution. I have every confidence.
Okay. All right. Ooh, there's one. All right, so what do I have to do here then? Ooh, hello.
Spread out.
Okay, loot. What's next? For the biggie, have we? Oh no, there's another one around the corner. Graphics are really nice. last one is this?
Children of the sea,
escape the ritual site.
Your bonds cannot hold the tempest.
Get rocking between, he said, didn't he? Oh, that seems to have done the trick. So, no, that's not lootable. Never mind.
Come, you must leave this place. Follow me.
Oh, okay, you're trying to kill me. What the hell?
My friend, to escape death so triumphantly is constant thrill, yes? Not so thrilling for the Maumer, of course.
How did you find me?
The Maumer are fled or dead thanks to your efforts. Kenarthi's roost is safe and voluntarily a part of the Aldmeri Dominion. So, if you must know, Razumdar keeps an eye on promising people.
Okay, complete quest.
If Raz had known you would do so well, he would have scrounged you a nicer reward. Apologies. The Mistral Armory is not what it once was.
Okay, so what now?
The Maumer are like drunken uncle. Chase them off, and they always come back. Next time, Kenarthi will be waiting for them. Problem is, there are places that will not be so prepared.
Okay, and where's that?
If the Vipers are here in numbers strong enough to assault Kenarthi, all of the southern seas are in danger. The Queen is in Oridon right now, beginning a royal visit. Raz would ask you to head to Volkel Guard and report to Watch Captain Astania.
Okie dokie.
Astania can pass word to Her Majesty. Perhaps you can catch a ride on the Prowler. Raz heard Jimila plans to set sail. He suspects she may owe you a favor.
Okay, got a few questions for you before I go.
Of course. After all you have done for us here, it would be rude of Raz to say no.
Who is this watch captain?
Astania's the lovely watch captain of the Volkel Guard Watch. Raz has shared more than one drink with the captain, and more than one fight. She's getting a bit grouchy now that she's tied to one port, but she should set you aright.
And what do you do, Raz?
This one is a simple Khajiit,
yeah,
like
right.
He said when we first met. He resolves issues as they come up. He acts in the best interest of the Dominion and the Queen.
Do you think I'll see you again?
Oh, Raz would not be surprised. You have already proven yourself a competent sword. Simple Khajiit like this one have a tendency to need competent people like you.
What can I expect in Oridon?
Very tall elves and very pretty shores. Oridon is the most worldly part of the Somerset Isles, and still many of the High Elves consider it a sanctuary away from the rest of the world. This one thinks they are kidding themselves.
Okay. See you later, Raz. Thanks for all your efforts. Right, who else we got here? What's this? Oh. Is this to move us away? Have we finished all the quests here? And why is that over there again? Settings, add-on settings, minimap. I want that over there, please. I thought we did that last episode. I obviously didn't lock it. There we go, let's lock it in place. Alright, let's resume.
The Prowler is headed to Oridon, and we're happy to ferry you there. When you're ready, hop in the launch. We'll set you up with your own bunk.
Okay.
Chests full of gold. Owning a sound ship after a hurricane can be quite lucrative, even when the only cargo is Dominion luminaries seeking passage. Don't worry, I won't charge you. Without your help, the Prowler would be a mass of broken timber.
Okay, goodbye. Well, it seems I've still got things to do here, so we won't be jumping on that boat straight away. Investigate the Temple of the Morning Springs. Looks like all these folks have been busy around here as well. Oops. There's something undiscovered over there. Do we jump into deep water and go and have a look? Or do we go here? Because it looks like we're pretty close. We'll go here. Alright, investigate the Temple of Morning Springs. Let's have a look. Of course, this is all back in this area again. Right. Ooh, we have a sky shard over there. Where is that? Let's head over that bridge. Oops, wrong
just
one.
Move along.
Yes, okay. Can I go this way? Let's try this way. Come on, jump up. You can do it. That's it. That little creature I summon makes some very disturbing noises. Collect the ritual resonance above, okay. Does that mean it's up there?
Don't
oh, no, it's here.
Her lies.
Harder than expected. See if it was worth it. Now
you die. Not now, not ever. We still need jute as well, don't we? If I remember correctly. Right, we've got something over there. Right that way. Something that way. Alright. Looks like I might be doing a little bit of running, folks. Let's speed it up a little bit. Oh, harpies. Keep your eye out for jute and other harvestables on the way. Really don't see too many of them, do you? Right, we've got Temple of Two Moons up there. Nella. Can't pass up lower. Thank you. Wood. Thank you. Right, we're nearly there for something. Sergeant Furion, okay.
Can any of you hear me? You there? Have you seen my squad?
Not sure what you mean.
We were all in a little Alkosh. part of the Dominion fleet sailing for Kanathi's Roost. Then a hurricane blew up out of nowhere. Sails tore, hulls cracked, and we were thrown into the ocean. I ended up here. I can't find the rest of my squad.
Did they survive the hurricane?
I thought I heard one of them calling out. But the ocean twists up sounds. If they're wounded or pinned down, could you keep an eye out for my soldiers? They answer to Edelus, Onglon, and Nistel. Two of us can cover more ground.
Okay, I'll help you.
I'm sure my squad made it to shore alive. Dominion Marines constantly defy the sea's attempts to drown us. But hurricanes have another matter. I fear my squad is banged up worse than
I can. I do about their wounds?
Our ship's hold was packed full of an old Bosma healing remedy. The labels say torch bug treacle, but Marines call it glow juice. The wreck scattered bottles across the beach must be what brought out the aelids.
Aelids? What do you mean?
Squat creatures made of teeth, claws, and endless hunger. I've heard their cries up and down the beach since I came to. Their sweet tooth is bigger than their walnut brains. I saw one of the stupid things swallow a whole bottle of glow juice.
If I see any, I'll bring Torchbug Treacle to your squad.
Good luck. Do me a favor. If you find them before I do, tell them the ocean hasn't killed me yet.
Okay. See you after. I take it it's down to the beach this way. Torchbug juice. Hello, Edelus.
Who are you? Were you part of the fleet?
Sergeant Furion sent me to find you.
Alive? Good. That's good. Wave smashed me against the ship. Cracked a few ribs. Not the best feeling.
Sergeant Furion said this Torchbug treacle would help.
Tastes like sandals boiled in mint perfume. But if it knits my ribs, I'll drink the whole bottle.
Okay, I'll look for the rest of your squad.
I'll find Sergeant Furion.
There's the Alites.
I lost a lot of friends in that storm. Give me some good news.
Sergeant Furion sent me to find you.
I saw her swept overboard in that damn storm. Held on to the rigging long as I could, but it tore the skin off my palms. If I can't hold a weapon, I'm useless to my squad. Do you have any bandages? I lost my kit to the sea.
This torch book of treacle might help.
Blow juice? Used to think this stuff was only good for practical jokes on snowy days. Once I can heft Spleen Shanker, I'll push through the beach and find Sergeant Furion. How about you?
Okay, I'll keep looking.
Hope they appreciate their good fortune when you find them. I can get inland after I rest. Fight with purpose.
All right then. Adios. Next. Oh, okay. You do that then. Is this the last one? Oops.
Malaeus Ifra, I'm glad you came by. Have you seen any other Marines along the beach?
Yes, the sergeant sent me.
She's alive. I suppose that's some luck amidst all this wreckage. Can't say the same for my leg. If I don't put too much weight on it, I can manage a good hobble.
I have this Torchbug treacle.
Glow juice? By the gods, it just might. As soon as I can stand on my own, I'll head inland.
Okay, I found everyone.
Lieutenant Gellin dragged me out of the water. He'll want to know Sergeant Furion and the rest of the squad are all right. I think he said something about looking for shelter in a nearby cave.
Oh, okay, that can't be good.
Still coughing up sand.
That cannot be good at all. looks like he's gone into a cave that's got spiders in it. Find Lieutenant Gillen. Is that you? Oh. Okay, that can't be good. Looks like he was sacrificed.
Turns out my squad were the ones who found me. Ever consider a career as a Dominion Marine? You'd make quite a scout. My squad said you were looking for Lieutenant Gillen. Have you found him?
Yeah, his body's in the cave. Someone killed him.
What do you mean?
It looked like he was killed in a ritual.
First, a hurricane blows out of nowhere and destroys our fleet. Then, an able-bodied Dominion Marine is captured and tortured to death. What else was in that cave?
Bones, candles, snakes, and a few wooden posts.
Some kind of sacrifice? This is too big for my squad to handle. We need reinforcements. Nistel spotted a beach ship nearby. It looks intact. And she spotted Dominion sailors aboard.
So what are you going to do?
We need to combine our forces and find who murdered Lieutenant Gillen. My squad and I need to pull his body out of that damn cave. Would you warn the sailors on that beach ship? They need to know it's not safe to wander around.
Okay, I'll warn
Wait.
Them.
Take this. I found some glow juice while I was looking for my squad. But they're on the mend. You'll get used to the taste. You'll be along shortly.
Okay.
Watch yourself.
See you in a while. Where are we headed? Well, the ship isn't too far away. Oh, hello.
What luck! The Prowler was untouched by the hurricane. Then, as we sailed past these shoals, a storm came out of nowhere and beached us. Wait, what are you doing here?
A marine was killed in a nearby cave.
The hurricane killed hundreds of marines. Why does it matter if one of them died in a cave?
He was murdered in ritual. His squad needs reinforcements.
Oh. Well, a prowler is like a hen in a wolf den until she's seaworthy again. Maybe your marines can prove they're more than two-legged cargo and shiny armor. If they pitch in, I'll consider reinforcements. They up for it? Or are they all talk?
I'm sure they'll help where they can.
And I'm sure they'll be as useful as they were in the hurricane. Should they care to prove otherwise, they're welcome to do actual work patching leaks in the Prowler's hold. Maybe they can locate a replacement helmsman's wheel in all this wreckage.
Okay, I'll look for the wheel and patch the ship.
Oh, and our sunsighter. Must have fallen overboard when we beached. Our lookout saw those skink-fingered pirates make off with it. You'll have to get the sunsighter back, any way you can.
Okay, goodbye. I'm not asking any more questions. What have we got here? Right, we've got something here. Ah.
These aren't Dominion sailors. They're privateers. Just our luck.
Oblon promised reinforcements when the Prowler's repaired.
Don't show that old sea cat what Dominion Marines can do.
Prowler needs a replacement helmsman wheel.
Edelus is the best scrounger in the regiment. If you want, I can send him out to look for a helmsman's wheel.
Yeah, okay.
He's on his way. Anything else we can do?
There are leaks on the Prowler that need patching.
Nistel is as good with a mallet as she is with a sword. I can have her patch the Prowler's leaks.
Yeah, have Nistel do it. Save me
She'll
doing
have
it.
Those leaks fixed in no time. What else?
Sea Viper stole the Prowler's sunsighter.
Onglorn is our best tracker. He can recover the sunsighter in no time.
Okay, off he goes then. Send him away.
I almost pity the Sea Viper who's holding on to the sunsighter. Onglorn will recover it soon enough. What else needs doing?
There's nothing left to do.
It's time for that mangy privateer to make good on his promise. Maybe you should do the talking. I'll just rub it in.
All right then.
That was fast. All right. There's room on the prowler for your marine friends, as long as they work for their meals.
And the reinforcements?
I said I'd consider it. Captain Jimala is the only one who can make that call.
And what does he say?
Something you'll want to hear. You just made the prowler seaworthy. And Captain Jimala always pays her debts. Go talk to her. She only bites if you give her good reason.
Okay. Hello, Jimala.
Due to your efforts, the Prowler is free to sail once the tide comes in. Those Marines did their part as well. I have no reinforcements, but I offer something better. I know who's killing the Dominion soldiers, and I know how to stop it.
Okay, tell me more.
Our lookout watched the Sea Vipers drag a Dominion Marine into a cave. Later, he saw your friends remove the Marine's body. If we weren't so short-handed, I'd have ordered his rescue. But three of my own crew were missing.
What happened to your crew?
Before we understood the danger, I sent my crew to scavenge among the shoals so we might repair the Prowler. We thought they disappeared, but one just returned, and she tells a harrowing tale.
And what happened?
The Sea Vipers happened. Now there's a new storm brewing, and I fear they're the cause of it. Mustengui recovers below. Hear what she has to say for yourself.
Okie dokie, we will do that. And I will probably do that in the downtime. I'll try and further this quest a bit further and maybe clear a few more off. We'll see. Alright, folks, well, thanks for watching. This is Al Grey, signing off.